First of all, we want to thank you for allowing us to come and visit. We always love coming here, Sue and I. We really do. It's a great pleasure to be invited. We love to hear about your triumphant exploits. It's nice, you know, the key, it's all about obedience, really, isn't it? That's the key to it. Everything's about obedience. It's being obedient and answering God's word. To me, being a Christian, well, it's a bit like David just said, it's a relationship. It's a relationship with God through Jesus Christ. Sue and I, you know, we do some outreach on a Saturday afternoon. We're going to Bournemouth and we get talking to a lot of Muslim people. And they're absolutely wonderful people. But they've got it so wrong, you know. It's all about like rules and good works. And we try and tell them about the grace of God. Because that's what it is. It's just that we cannot enter salvation without God's grace. I found Jesus, you know, has been speaking to me of late. There's been two things that he's been speaking to me. One of them is about love. It's his last commandment, you know, to love one another as he has loved us. And the Greek word for that love, and I'm sure you all know, is agape. Agape love is a serving, sacrificial love. And I've had to question myself on this. You know, I think serving, I think to a degree we all do a bit of serving, we all do something. But it's to sacrifice. And I've had to question myself, how much sacrifice do I give? Can I honestly put my hand on my heart and say that I live a serving, sacrificial life, fully devoted to the Lord Jesus? And I'm not sure that I can. I've had to sit down, you know, and I've had to question, do I wait for opportunities? Or do I go out and create them? Do I find them? You know, John Wimber, he was the founder of the Vineyard Movement. And John Wimber said, if you want to work for God, look where the Spirit is moving and join in. And I don't think that's a bad thing to do. And this is exactly what we did when we started doing the outreach. We were trying to get involved with the church that we go to. And they're not that good at coming forward with things like outreach. So we prayed and we asked God. And he guided us exactly there. And we fit in so well. And we love it too. And I think that's the key. It's actually love what you're doing for God. The second, it's about faith. It's an obedient faith, a relational faith, an audacious faith. And I think, to be honest, I think they're all the same. I think it's about being bold, daring and confident, even being a bit cheeky or risky. If you want to walk upon water, that's where you've got to be. You've got to get out of the boat. Jesus was the only person to call God Abba. You know, and that word Abba, we don't have an English word to translate Abba. The nearest I can come to it is, have you ever seen, you've seen that film Railway Children? We've all seen it, haven't we, Railway Children? Do you know that last little bit where Jenny Agutter sees her father get off the train and she says, Daddy, my daddy. It's that bit, that's how I see Abba, that personal daddy. And that's where we've got to be. That's the relationship that we have to have with God. And that's the relationship that God wants with every one of his children. And it's that relationship that produces childlike faith, a Bible-believing faith, and anything you pray for in my name will happen faith, a walk on water faith. That's the relationship that we need. When Sue and I first become Christians, we had this beautiful start to our Christian life. God took us to the most beautiful church you could imagine. It was a Nazarene church. And our pastor always used to say it. I didn't know how to take it at the time, to be honest. But he always used to say, you've got a childlike faith. You believe everything. And that's where we were. We actually believed everything. Whatever the Bible said, we believed it. And it was the little things, you know, it's like silly little things. Like, we used to have a solid fuel central heating system. And it was such a pain to light in the morning. And we always used to pray, you know, please, Lord, get the fire started. And we'd take the kids to school, we'd come back and we'd have a roaring fire. And I think that's what it is with God, isn't it? It's dotting the I and crossing the T's. It's the little bits. And I think that's what it's all about. It's giving everything to God and God being the centre of our life. You know, last week, Sue and I visited a church, the King's Church, it was, in Palmer. And there was a lady there that prayed. And these words have stuck with me. Part of her prayer was, it was never the nails that held Jesus to the cross. It was his love. And that's one for David. That's a wow factor. And that's what Jesus means to me. It's the love that held him on that cross. For each and every one of us. That's my Jesus.